Hey folks, it's James here, or Movie Mad, whichever you like to call me. I did do some hunting this week, and I went on all my routes, and I'll be honest with you, I started filming two or three of them, but to be honest with you, I didn't find enough or do footage to make it in a video, so I actually just went and deleted it all. I'll try and do some hunting this weekend, if possible. But I have got some pickups and some things I received through the mail over the last couple of days. This is since last Saturday that I received all these things. So first of all, I shall show you the DVD pickups I picked up. And I picked up, I think I've got season 1, 2 and 3 of this already. I haven't actually watched this, but I've always thought it'd be a good show. And that's Modern Family season 4. So I picked that up. I also picked up a season of Two and a Half Men. Oh, this one's opening up at the bottom. It's alright, it seems like there's a loose disc in here as well. We don't want that, do we? No, it's alright. Oh, there we go. And I have picked this, I have watched Two and a Half Men from start to finish. On there, so I would like to pick up all the seasons if possible, but this is the first one I've actually seen out and about to do, and that was season 5. Just to let you know, all these four were 4 for a pound, so about 25p each per series, which is pretty good. So be all itchy. There we go. And I also picked up another season of Two and a Half Men, and that one's sealed, and that was season 7. There you go. I also picked up this. I have watched this from start to finish as well, and that's How I Met Your Mother, and this is season 6. So again, I'd like to get all of them, but this is the first start on it. So after the last video, I look at that. That's just for Blu-ray. We'll look at that. There you go, Pete. As you can see, just before I show you, I've got Pete in the background, just for you. Blu-ray Bullet Brit in the background there. Right, so before I continue with the pickups, I was going to show you what I've got for his prize to send off, but I'll tell you what, I'll leave that to Pete to show you. So, I also picked up a few from Amazon on my £15 voucher, and I had another, I think I had £8 from Top Cashback. Right, I'm going to have to stop because Jax is chewing the receipt from the shelter shop.
Jax!
Jax!
Should I bring him over to me
and I'll look after him? Oh. See? Hello, Jax. See, don't bite the receipt from the shelter shop, please. Right, go and see your sister.
Come see Molly.
Okay. Molly will look after him when we're filming.
I'll give him a cut.
Yeah, okay. So I did order some stuff from Amazon. I think I spent about £23 in total on Amazon. And one of the films I bought was The Power Rangers. And that, to be honest with you, I wasn't thinking much of this. I thought I'm going to watch this on Netflix. And actually, I thought it was a really good movie. So I've got that. As you can see, this one does have the digital code. Now, I think I'm going to do something different with digital codes, because someone said that the last one I gave out the digital codes, they were all gone within 2 minutes. So what I'm going to do is, if you want the digital code for any of these that I'm showing you, message me and tell me which one you want. And I'll spread them out evenly, shall we say, on there. So, and you, if you go onto Facebook, I'll put my link in there, and that's Movie Mad, and you can message me on there, and you can get the digital code for it if you want. So, Power Rangers, Blu-ray and digital download on there. So I got that, and I paid £4.99 for that, I believe. I also picked up a couple from CX just today, and these are the ones I got. 2012, I actually think that's a really good film, and I don't think I've got it on Blu-ray yet, so a slipcover, decent condition, for 50p, I took that. I also took The Bourne Supremacy. I don't think I've got any of them on Blu-ray yet, but again, for 50p, I thought that would start me off. And I bought Alien 3, and this is maybe a double dip, as you whatever you call it, for me, but I'll explain why in a minute or two. I also picked up Jurassic Park, And there we go, and that's got the on there. They did actually have the 3 set in there of Jurassic Park, and the other two after that was the Lost World, and I can't remember the last one's name, but they had them. And I was actually going to pick up the triple set for £8, but then I seen that the CEX, I thought this looks like an awfully dodgy cover, and it was. It was one of the reprinted covers, so I didn't pick that up, I just picked up the one. I also picked up a film I actually just watched on Amazon last night, and that is The Imitation Game. Now, I've actually seen this 2 or 3 times already. I just think it's a really good film, and it's about Alan Turing, who's the guy who breaks the Enigma code in Bletchley Park. And it's got a sort of like a biographical one of them, and I think it's a good one. He always seems to play or can act really well. I think he does. Anyway, one exception to that is I think Into the Darkness, where he's Can. I just don't think he can live up to the original guy. But again, who could? I also picked up this interesting little booklet, and that is The Graduate, and it says the Studio Canal Collection in a sort of nice wee case there. So I always liked Dustin Hoffman, and I've seen The Graduate, and it's got a nice wee book. Nice wee parts on it, and I just thought it was a really nice case, and for £4 I picked that up. Hey, just to let you know, I didn't actually spend any money, this is all this sort of credit that I've been saving up on there. I've been waiting for this to drop down in price a little bit too, and it was 10 and it was 8 and then it was 7 and I thought, get that. So I've seen this has been, I've not actually seen the movie, but I've seen this has been heavily publicised and people saying it's really good. So I thought for £7 I'll pick that one up too. This might be a shock to some people in terms of quality wise, but I picked up Tom Cruise The Mummy, and it's Blu-ray and digital download, and it was £4.99. For £4.99, I think, was the film great? No. Was it watchable? Yes. Is it going to reinvigorate all the whole monsters genre for Universal? I don't think so, but it was pretty decent. So for £4.99, I think it might even have been £3.99. I picked it up. What I spent the bulk of my money on in the Amazon was this for £13.49, and that's the Alien six film collection. It comes with Alien, Aliens, Alien 3, Alien Resurrection, Prometheus, and Alien Covenant. Now, when I picked up the Alien 3 in CEX, what I was thinking about is the Chris Stuckman review Alien 3, where it says there's a totally different cut off it, an extended cut, that changes the whole perspective of the movie. And I thought, you know, Alien 3, I think it was an okay movie. I don't think it was terrible, as most people think so. Alien Resurrection, now there's a terrible movie, but there you go. And what I was interested in, I wasn't sure if this set has that cut on it, and I still don't know. So that's why I picked up the Alien 3 from CEX, because it says it includes the 1992 theatrical version and the 2003 special edition. So I'm presuming that's the one that Chris Stuckman, they have our conversation about it on there. So I got that too. Let me sort of these pickups. So I picked up another few bits and pieces. I picked up The Walking Dead, a complete third series for £4.99. Now that's a lot for me for a series, but I like The Walking Dead. I like the slipcover. It was in really good condition. And look, as I say that, the discs are slipping out. Look, dear oh dear. Got to be good. Slide these in. Don't I break it. There we go. So I paid £4.99 for that. Now you can, I say in CEX, I think it costs a little bit more than that, or roughly the same. But I thought, when you go to CEX, there isn't always the selection you're looking for. So I thought, better get that while I can. So I picked that up, and it was £4.99. So, bit of bit expensive, but I did pay that for it. Also seen in the... It was the Heart Foundation shop. The Hobbit Battle of the Five Armies 3D. Now, you see the Unexpected Journey and Desolation in Smog 3D quite often, but you don't always see this one, and I thought that was a pretty decent price for it. Because I say, I think it costs a lot more than that in CX. Correct me if I'm wrong on there. So, there we go, I'm breaking it again. Movies falling out everywhere. Yeah, gotta be careful. They jammed in the school. I'm not having much luck today, am I? There we go. So, I don't even have a 3D TV, but one day I hope to obtain one of them and have a little look and see how these look. So, I thought I can take that one and I can trade in my Battle of the Five Armies too. Or, what I might do is I might just throw it into the competition. So, there we go. I also picked up Barbarella for £3, and again, I've never seen this film, but it's Jane Fonda, and from what I know, it's supposed to be a bit of a classic, so I'll watch that one too. I also picked up a couple of seasons of Deep Space Nine, and they were £1.99 each on there. I do like Deep Space Nine. Marina Sirtis, she likes to call it Deep Sleep Nine. But I actually think it was a bit more gritty than The Next Generation, a bit more war, a bit more intrigue. Some of the things they done in the war, you know, were betraying Starfleet, shall we say, morals and things like that. But that's what real life is. But Next Generation and Star Trek were more, you know, like idealistic one. I think this was more a bit realistic, and I did like it. So I have got most of the scenes of that. I didn't have those two, I don't think. And I'm still not sure because I've not checked, but I picked up those two just in case as well. I have been looking out for this as well. I may have showed you this in the last video, I don't know. But that is, I think I've paid 25p for this one as well, and that is The Fall, first season, starring Gillian Anderson and who else is it? Is it Henry Cavill? Or is the guy, it's Jamie Dornan, it's the guy out of 50 Shades, probably all of that. But perhaps he's a better character in this than he is in 50 Shades. So I got that too. I also, as I said, I had picked up some Sky movie rewards from my energy supplier, which is British Gas, and they had them for £5.99. They also had those Nestle bots where you could get £5.99, so worth the movie voucher. So I done that and I picked up, or I got sent to me, this. So let's have a look. Oh, it's got a nice cover on it too, look, I didn't expect that. There you go. And that is Spider-Man Homecoming on Blu-ray. There you go. So yeah, happy with that too. Oh, it also has a digital copy on that one. I see, so there you go. So that's pretty good. I'm presuming it's inside on there. So that was all my pickups for this week. As I say, I hope to get... That was a good catch, Molly.
Thanks.
I'm planning to do a bit more hunting this weekend. I'm trying to do it on a budget. I say, I spent 14, maybe £15 there, and the rest was all CEX credit. Now I have got more credit to spend in CEX, which I'll no doubt use, but I like to when the films first come out, like Rampage, Ready Player One, things like that, they're always at 15, 12, they drop down to 8, they drop down to 6, and I like to get them when they drop down to £6, £8. Just depending on how much credit I've got, to be honest with you. Sometimes I even let them drop to 4 before I'll actually buy them. The only thing is, I actually went and get Rampage today because I seen it drop to 8 or 10 in CEX and somebody snatched up the copy. So that's the risk you take when you wait that little bit longer. No doubt it'll probably come back in. As I said, just a shout out to Pete, we're going to do it a bit. He's obviously done his video today. I haven't watched it yet, but I'm going to. And he's chucked in a few other bits and pieces for the prizes, I believe. So we're for the big October prize. So just remember, if you want to enter that, you've got to subscribe to both me and Blue Ray Bullet Brit and friend us on Facebook. What I'll do is I'll use my Movie Mad Facebook page for that, and I'll put a link in the description below for you. Actually, I'm going to put a link, so if you do want to subscribe, and hopefully it's going to appear here when I do the edit on there. So I'm going to do that for you in just a second or two. I say I have got a few other prizes that I'm going to throw into the competition, but I'll be posting them to Pete, and I'll let him show you, shall we say. So I thank you for watching. I say I haven't made many videos this week. Hopefully I'll get that rectified over the weekend. But thanks for watching, guys, and always a pleasure. Thanks. Oh, if you do want to comment down below, just remember, and I say, if you do want to get any of the digital codes that were in there, I can't even remember what ones there were, but do that on my Movie Mad page and message me on there. Cheers. Thanks, guys.